Hello, all and sundry, streaming again, twitching like crazy. Got a share to the socials. Yes, I'm Cobb. I just went away and had some dinner, and now I'm painting again. It's basically my Saturday night. Oh, g'day, mate. I'm trying to work out how to add a link to my story on Instagram. I'm not very good at it. Alright, I think I managed to add it. I did. Go team. Alright. And I'll just go Twitter again. I'm so good at social media. I'm like the social media guru, social media whisperer. Not really. This guy's finished, so I'm just gonna take this off. This is a satisfying moment, peeling the masking tape away from the base. Super satisfying. Usually drop the model two or three times during this process as well. which is fun. Cool. My guy. Tough look for my guy. Sweet. Alright, now we'll get back to painting this guy. For reals. So I ended up watching WandaVision whilst I was having my dinner. Very interesting. I won't say that it was not what I expected, because it was what I expected based on some of the preview reviews that I had read, but I'm excited to see where it goes. Well, Zom Cobb, it is the latest Marvel product released on their streaming platform Disney Plus. Came out yesterday. Well, the first two episodes did anyway. I'm a bit of a Marvel fanboy. Love their stuff. Yes, that is the plan indeed. Gonna do the gold on the chest things first. Ah, yes, indeed, Jeffrey. One of the advantages of having no children. Archer from Warhammer Quest. Wow. Never played Warhammer Quest. I always wanted to. I was a child in that era, so I didn't have any money. But we did play a little bit of Hero Quest back in the day. So that was cool. Ah, hello there, Topulus. Maybe I should post in the Kingdom Death Discord and tell everyone I'm streaming. Maybe you can do it for me. Like a good dude. Hello, Nick. Can you get these down there, GT? Burly big heads? Good beer, carb free. Thanks, Topulus. I'm painting, mate, so I'm focusing on my painting. Ah, awesome. Good beers. I like them. 2008. Long time ago now. Just trying to remember what I was doing in 2008. That was the heyday of the Warhammer time in our lives, wasn't it, Jeffy? Oh, maybe not the heyday, maybe that was a few years before. 2009 was the year I went overseas for the ETC for the first time. But I think that was Warhammer in its glory days was, for us, was probably before that. Don't know. Sign of beef. Pals. Yeah. Cool. Tail end, yeah. Kids, mate. In case you're wondering why I keep looking up at the webcam or just to the side, there's a TV up there. I'm watching the cricket at the same time. They go the Big Bash. Cricket's a very popular sport in Australia, if you're from the other side of the world. Yeah, it really does. And some of the South Asian countries, India, Sri Lanka, it's very popular there. Bangladesh. Yeah, it's a very specific sport. Yeah. I actually did something fun with my girlfriend. I tried to explain to her how cricket works. I think we had an hour conversation, and by the end of it, she still had no idea how cricket works. So it's a bit funny that way. Imagine it's a bit like baseball. Hello, awesome guy. Thanks for following my cool Twitch stream. What an awesome guy you are. G'day, Morsk 32. It is not morning here. It is 7 o'clock in the evening. I've just been told my stream is boring and I need to take my top off. I shan't be doing that. Oh, hello, Widgekurt. Cool. Thanks for following. Whatever that means. Can someone explain to me what that actually means on Twitch? Because I have no idea. Cool. Does it work? Like, do you get live real-time notifications? Cool. Alrighty. Feel free to ask any questions about why I'm doing things. Don't really know if I'll be able to explain them, but I'll certainly try. Wickert? Wickert? I've never watched Star Trek: The New Next Generation. I've watched 6 episodes, and I was inspired to watch those 6 episodes after I watched Star Trek Discovery, the second season. And I was flicked onto it because I was right into Star Trek, so I got about 6 episodes in. It hasn't aged well. So Wicket. Hello, Catichius. Wow, this is good fun. Look at me mispronouncing names like crazy. Oop. So if you're just joining the stream, this dude was started today on a stream about 4 hours ago. So if you want to know how we got to this stage, you'll be able to watch it back. I'm going to try and upload it to my YouTube if I can figure out how to carry them from Twitch to YouTube. Hopefully in a way that doesn't involve me downloading and then re-uploading. Surely there would be a way. That is my plan for tonight, after I finish painting. Topulus, you're doing some cool stuff at the moment, mate. Yes. My work phone's ringing. It's Gavin Clark. Gavin. Let's call Gavin live on stream. Oh, here we go. Gavin. You're live on stream at the moment, mate. I'm streaming to Twitch. So you're not coming over for a paint tomorrow? Okay. Just painting a dude, painting a little vampire dude. Ooh, it was gonna be next week. Well, stop piking on me. Stop piking on me then. Yeah. Okay, sounds good. See you, mate. Classic. Oh, sorry, Jeff, I missed that. Yeah, we'll get him to clean the airbrush live. Classic. He was supposed to come around for a paint tomorrow, old Gavin. And as always, has had to pike something else. Just not that important to him, I'm afraid, these days. Don't rate. It's all about that netball life now, Jeff. You know how it is, mate. Cool, Topulus. Yeah, I mean, I think there's a lot of ways to do non-metallic metal, right? The way that I do it is probably more cartoony than some of the other people I've seen. Some of the many other people I've seen do it. But it is quick, it is easy, and it is fun, so those are more important to me than being as good as the Lands and Kirills of the world. I will try and do something like those guys at some point. Yeah, Grand Poppy Gav, eh? That's cool, Catitius, that you saw that video. Probably my favorite bit about that video is when I do the airbrush glaze over the top. I'm thinking about doing something similar on this one. Maybe, we'll see. All right, let's do some stuff on the face. So, so I said at the tail end of my last stream that I wasn't happy with the face at the moment. The way that this model is shaping up, you've got all this cool non-metallic metal which is drawing your eyes, and that's not what you want your focal point to be generally. There are exceptions to that rule. The rule of cool, for example, takes precedence. But I wanted this guy's face to be the actual focal point of the piece. And so the way I'm going to do that is add some red tones into the face that are quite strong. And I'm also going to attempt to up the focus. The value in a way that is not shithouse. So let's see how that goes, shall we? Oh, remind me, I've got to do the hand too. Don't let me miss this hand. I'm really bad at painting hands. I always forget them. I get super excited about faces and chests and shoulders and stuff, and then forget about the wee old hands. I actually like painting hands, particularly Lucas's penis sculpt. He's got the best hands out there. So the colors on this model have just sort of evolved. If you have a look at the first layers of metal, they were sort of more. I started with this color, Frozen Flesh from Nocturna. And so they were kind of like a purpley tinge, and then it's just gone in a different direction. Possibly driven by the fact that that cloak, I decided to make it ready purple. So, oopsies. Yeah, the hands on every Lucas sculpt is just like delightful. The guy is my favorite sculptor. Catch that, caveat that, my favorite physical sculptor because the sculpts just feel so alive. How's the focus going? Focus in camera. Need to get some red. I sure do. Charles Aegis, CA Sculpts, did most of the Limbo range. He does some cool stuff. Is it struggling? Is it struggling to focus? No. It isn't anymore. All right. Oh, he's done. Done some absolute bangers. He didn't do this model, the one that I'm painting now, but he did did the majority of the Limbo range, which has some really cool models. And I don't think he did this one. He might have. Oh, maybe he did. What a legend. Hello, Benny. I don't fuck spiders, mate. Get in and paint some shit. We'll see. We'll see how the skin ends up. You know, I remember when I painted the bust version of this, that I really struggled with the face, and it shouldn't have been something that I struggled with, because it's actually a really interesting sculpt with lots of dynamic shapes and volumes. But I just remember I couldn't get it to feel right. Ended up being not my favorite thing I'd painted that week. You guys were supposed to remind me to paint the hand. I forgot again. Fuck. Well, at the moment, mate, I'm just most keen to paint the Camelot models. Got a big project idea in mind with them, so I'm really, really excited to paint them. But they are still on their way, as I understand it, so we're not likely to see them for a little while. But I'm also doing a diorama of Drizzt and the other Forgotten Realms dudes, so I've got two of the five models I'm going to use for that. So that'll be cool. And yeah, I mean, aside from that, you can probably not see quite behind me, but I've got a stash there. Just here, which has some of my treasures. The old lady with her cup. Excited about that one. The old lady with her something, I don't remember. These old ladies, by the way. Just check this out, by the way. Oh, but Ben, my good friend, that is not the last of them. That is not the last of them. They are impossible to get. They are all just in case you can't see that. That says 12 of 37. Yes. I feel for you, mate. I feel for you. No, look, I have no idea what I'm going to paint those witches. I have never felt confident enough to paint them. And at this juncture, I don't think I'll have time to paint them this year. Maybe I will. We'll see. Maybe. Maybe. Don't know. They are the most expensive models I have bought, which is not my justification for not painting them. They are my favorite models I've ever bought. That is my justification for not painting them. Just can't get over how awesome the sculpts are, and it just makes me want to do the best job I can. All right. This face is shithouse, so let's make it less shithouse by using something that makes me look better than I am. I don't have the alchemist, I'd like him. So I do this weird thing where every time he releases a new sculpt, I'm like, I don't know, I don't really love it, eh? Unless it's one of the witch, unless it's a witch, and then I'll just buy it straight away. But the pirates, I was like, don't know if I love the pirates. And then when the models get released out in the wild, and I look at them again, I'm like, fuck, I really want the pirates, man. How annoying. And so I have to end up paying a lot more money for them than I would have needed to on the secondary market because I just didn't buy them in the first place, like a peanut. Yeah, that's what I should do. That's what I should do. But I forget. Yeah. Well, guess what, mate? There's a guy sitting right here who might want to buy them. Because he did the same thing with the seven dwarves. Like a fucking idiot. Yeah. We'll see. It's time for my favorite contrast paint. This is just what happens with my painting. I'll try something and it doesn't work the way I want it to. So I tweak it. Usually I can get it somewhere that I like. Batman. That's good, Jeffy. Hooray! Hello, Dat Daney, you legend. Huh. See you, Ben. Glasses, eh, Jeffy? Unlucky, pal. Unlucky. Just going to crack another beer whilst this varnish dries. Stand by. While the varnish is drying, you can have a look at this dude who's finished now because I added some blood spatter to him. Yeah, blood and gore. I added it. Finishing touches. Yeah, there's a few things I'd change about this guy, but I'm relatively happy with him. Big shot. All right. You can, Dat Daney, you can. Practice, 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 mate. There are many people in this chat stream that have known me for years and know that I was particularly shithouse at painting. Few years ago. So you can do it. Yes. So I think the skin looks slightly better now. Thoughts? Sure is, mate. Sure is. And I, for one, cannot wait for Echoes of Cat. Oh, thanks, Jeff. I fucking forgot the hand, didn't I? What an idiot. All right. Hand can be more red. Nobody breathe. Stupid eyes. better. So one thing I do regularly is actually take the model outside of the lighting from here to have a look at it outside in normal lighting. Gives you a much better perspective on if you have enough contrast or if you need more contrast. So you see me do that quite a lot normally. Still need to get some contrast in most areas. We just ticked over 3.5 hours worth of work on this guy, all on stream. Yes. I'm doing the hand, Jeffrey. Stupid hand sucks. I hate it. Just holding a stupid sword. Hate everything about this hand. Why are you forcing me to paint you, hand? I hate you. You make a good point, Jeff. What do you mean the hair? And the what? And the ears. No one's going to look at the back. He's going to sit on a stool, either in my display cabinet or in someone else's display cabinet. And that is it. He doesn't get picked up and turned around much. It's okay if the back of his ears are sloppy. It's one of the reasons, yes. That because I could use brown with a wash like a boss. He's going right, I reckon. Might be time to switch it up a bit, actually. Paint some rocks. This is going to be a disaster, this rock painting experience, because I literally just mash up colors that I've got on my palette for the rocks. So you will see all of the colors that are on the base that are on the model, and it won't make a lot of sense to begin with, probably. Maybe not at the end either, actually. Let's wait and see. This is this guy's base, by the way. I don't know if I specified that. I assumed it would have been relatively obvious, but... that's the base that came with the model, my guy. Stuck on a plinth. This is actually why I like painting rocks, because you can just do whatever you want and they always turn out awesome because they're rocks. It's spot on. Jeffy, I don't know if Nicole's watched it already, mate, but fully got into Bridgerton. Love the shit out of Bridgerton on Netflix. Just get amongst it. I'll tell you what I was addicted to last year, Downton Abbey. Couldn't get enough Downton Abbey. What a great show. Bridgerton's like Downton Abbey meets Gossip Girl. Yep, what a legend. Good taste, that woman. Outside of the man she picked to marry. She had an opportunity to marry me, mate, and for some reason she chose you. Rookie mistake. How is Kel? Yeah. Doesn't surprise me. Just repeat, mate. I could have been her second marriage. Should have given me a call. What an awful mistake she's made with her life. Very true. Very true. The complete package. Surely am, my friend. I just remembered I can mute audio. So you don't have to listen to the hairdryer if I'm going to be doing an extended dry. Oh, crowd catch goes down. This is why painting rocks is the best. So what I try and do with rocks and with bases in general is tie the colors of the base together with the model so that it feels like a cohesive environment. And a cohesive piece. So you can feel like this dude is standing on these rocks and it doesn't feel out of place because the colors are similar. The colors on the base tend to be darker because you don't want the base to be drawing more focus than the model. There you go. The base is made of the base that came with the model, stuck on a plinth and some sand. And that is it. Certainly is. Big minis are the best. Time for a test fit. Needs to be darker. Yeah, I think you learn more from painting big models than you do from painting small models. Just force you to think more about volumes and shapes and yeah. Which hobby shop are you going to? Chum Dab? Oh, Fionn, I don't want to become famous, no. I'm already famous, mate. I don't need big follows. Like my handle's Big Deno, mate. Come on now. Pull your head in. I'll look into how to do that. I'm sure there's an easy way. Oh, camera's frozen again. Oh, that's a shame. I thought I fixed that problem. All right, well, I was pretty much done anyway for the evening, so yeah. Cheers. Here's my guy. I'm sure you can see really clearly in this camera. Hey, wee. Yeah, so I had this problem a little while back. Where the camera, the feed from the main camera, stopped working. And I'm not sure why. So, wonder if there's an easy way for me to fix it. Trying to fix the camera. Yeah, the audio is not a problem. I'm still getting audio fine. I'm still getting that webcam fine. It is just the Elgato Cam Link that is struggling to keep up. It'd be nice to find a way to fix it. Whilst the stream is still running. Got my hand now. Yeah. This is where this dude's gonna end today. He looks pretty good. Yeah, so that's a total of about 4 hours of painting for these two elements. And I think that showcased most of the techniques that I use relatively well. From here, I'll probably continue to refine the metals themselves. To get them to look convincing, you need to have a very clear light to dark, for my technique anyway. And some of these areas, we don't have enough dark, creating the contrast to make it look like metal. His sword still needs to be tweaked, and then I'd like to fix a little bit of this area here. This light is obviously coming from the top down, it's hitting here, should be traveling a little bit further down and perhaps a little bit more down here as well. I need to do this bit, I need to do the metal on his legs. It's quite noticeable, the legs, when you put him on the base, that they need to be tweaked just like the rest of the metal. And then there's these straps and these bits and pieces. So, I mean, all up, I could probably knock it over in about an hour, I think. But I quite like this model, so I'll probably spend a bit more time just enjoying painting, enjoying the experience. So, yeah, I'll probably aim for like 6 hours on this dude to finish this dude off. So, pretty cool. Any questions before I shut up shop for the evening? The next model I'll paint on stream will probably be this girl. Same manufacturer. It's the Lady of the Lake. She's carrying Excalibur. Sweet. I actually felt like... Yeah, that's not a bad idea, Jeff. Not a bad idea. Could look good in the gold, actually. In a gold colour. I do want to try and do some more non-metallic detail work, so maybe I'll do that. Good suggestion. Oh. Josh Philippi just got clocked in the jaw. Yeah, good idea. I did a sheer dress for an Egyptian lady a little while back, and I obviously did it for that angel and demon bust. And yeah, I don't know. I don't think I'll do a sheer dress on her. She is wet, obviously. She's a Lady of the Lake, but who knows? Yeah. Spot on. The box art for both of these models, the Lady of the Lake and that Demeter von Gore, are just sublime. If you haven't seen them, you should go and check them out. Land Studio does Demeter von Gore, and Mikhail Shimenshko, who's Mihals, does the Lady of the Lake. And they're both unbelievable, unbelievable models. Yeah, coolio. Well, I'll catch you all next stream. I'm probably just going to tweet about it or Instagram or something. Rock on. Have a great evening, whatever you're doing, or day or morning, wherever you are.